After all, how could a woman turn down a man who puts such heart into asking her to be his wife? Well, let me tell you about my next guest. He took his declaration of love all the way to the big screen. Please welcome Ken Newman and Kristen Koenig. Hi. Nice to see you both. Thanks very much for being here. Now, you had a whole production going on that involved a drive-in. Tell me about this.
Well, I made a short film and showed it at the drive-in movies. The film was a collage of pictures of me and Kristen. And at the end, it said, "Will you marry me?" And it was shown at the drive-in in between the movies during intermission. And I had all of our friends and family in the audience in cars hidden, so she didn't know.
That is so creative. But now, are you a filmmaker?
No.
It's really just adorable. I want to show a clip of it so everybody can see exactly your effort, what put together at the drive-in. So watch your monitors. Here we go.
Whenever I see your smiling face, I have to smile myself. Because I love you, yes I do. And when you give me that pretty little pout, it turns me inside out. There's something about you, baby, I don't know. Isn't it amazing a man like me can feel this way? Tell me how much longer, it will grow stronger every day. Times before with the girl next door, but that was long before I met you. Now I'm sure.
Oh. Ken, way to go. Good job. Kristen, he got very good photos of you.
He found them in my drawers.
Actually, that's kind of a funny story behind that. I had to go through her. I didn't have really any pictures of her, and I had to go through her drawers to try to find pictures of us together because there were so few of them. And she busted me going through her drawers and was like, "You're going through my drawers?" I'm like, "Trust me, you'll forgive me."
Oh, you didn't even have a good excuse?
No. Well, I didn't know what to say. I'm like, "Well, I just sort of wanted to."
Through my stuff.
It's a violation of trust, honey, if you think I am. Now, what were you thinking about when you saw this come up on the big screen unexpectedly?
I thought it was someone else. I really didn't know. I had no idea. None at all. I kept on saying, "What's this? What's this?" You know, and then my pictures are up there and he's like, "Just watch it, just watch it." And I was just very surprised.
And then
I had
right
no
afterwards,
idea.
Then what did you say? Your friends and family all came bounding out of their cars?
After I gave her the ring, yeah. In fact, she didn't know what to say. And then
I didn't even say yes. Yeah.
Right away.
Until someone said, "What did you say?"
Look at your reaction. Now, who's this? Is this mom?
That's
this
my
is
mother.
Oh, and look at you, Ken, so proud of yourself.
I stood just holding the ring for a while.
What a wonderful memory as you begin your life together. Now, you two actually won a contest, didn't you? The Ross Jewelers' most creative way to say, what is it? True Love Stories Contest. So when are you going to become Mr. and Mrs.?
September 29th.
This year.
Are you going to do a traditional wedding, or do you have something up your sleeve for that, too?
It's going to be fairly traditional. Nothing, you know. It's not going to be on the drive-in movies or anything like that.
Oh, you'll send us videotape, though, right?
Yeah. Sure. Okay.
What a great memory scrapbook for your future kids, which I expect will be there. That's nothing like putting them on the spot, is it? They're here. It's like a tell-all kind of thing.
Someday.
You're a really great couple. Thank you so much.
Thanks.
Good going. Very romantic. Good luck to you. We'll be back in just a few minutes, and when we return, you'll hear some more true love stories, and we'll meet a couple that got a standing ovation from 1,500 people when he asked, "Will you?" And she said, "Yes." Stay with us. We'll be right back. They say she's...
And there's...